Hello guys, so today I'm going to be installing my new head unit and my Lamborghini Gallardo. This is what the box looks like. I ordered it from, I'm not sure the website, but I can put a link in the description. But it came from Hong Kong and it only took 3 days to get here, which is pretty fast. I also ordered a front camera, so like a dashboard camera so I can put in the front, and it just hook up directly with the USB. I already took out the head unit out to the car, but I had a little issue with the key to remove the old head unit. So I actually had to go to Audi and call a bunch of different Audi dealership to see if they have any of the key in stock. And fortunately, they had one in stock from a dealer 30 miles away. So I went there to get the new key, which I'll show you in a little bit. But here are some of the wiring tool. Oh my gosh. And they actually have the key in here already. Look at that. So I wasted my time to go get a bunch of keys, but it looks like it has some in here already, so you guys wouldn't have to mess with that. Okay, let me get you to the car and show you. Okay, so I'm out here in my garage. I'm gonna install the head unit. I still can't believe they have the key in here. I should have looked before. I thought this box was just an empty box, but so I ordered this right here from Audi. Well, I didn't order it. I went to the dealership and got it. But I do notice this key was the one I ordered online, and you see how it's curved a little bit? This one did not work. So I went to Audi and ordered this one, and this one's a little bit more flat. If you can see that. See? But then the key in the package from the head unit, aftermarket head unit, it's also kind of round looking, so I'm afraid this one might not work either. So good thing, because see, as you can see, it looks similar to the one that I did order online and it did not work. So maybe this one might not work, but I'm gonna give it a shot and see if there's a difference. But this is the one where I went to Audi and actually bought, and it, you can see it's a little bit more sharp looking compared to this. Let me see if I can show you. You see? A little bit of difference. Also with the one that came in the head unit. Let me see if I can show you. See? It looks different. So I'm gonna see which one actually worked. Maybe my extra effort did pay off at the end, but let me get in the car and I'll let you guys know. Okay guys, now I'm in my Gallardo. It's a 2005, and this was the key that I originally bought separately, because I was afraid the head unit that I ordered, the aftermarket one, did not come with it. So this is supposed to stick in here like this. And then what you do, you push it all the way in, and then there's four of them, one here, right there, and right there. But these ones don't work for some reason, so let me try the one that came with the head unit and see if that works. Sorry, I'm trying to do this with one hand, just kind of want to give you my issues that I come across so you guys don't have to deal with the same thing. I noticed there's not many videos that show the head unit installation for the Lamborghini instead of the Audi. So this is, looks like the one I just ordered, but this is in the box with the aftermarket head unit. Let me see if this works. Hang on a second. Oh, it did not work. So my effort to go to Audi was not a waste. So these keys, the round looking one, do not fit. So let me try the Audi one that I went to the dealership and purchased. So this is what the bag looked like. If you guys want to take a visual look to see the, I guess what the stock number or whatever it is, and see if you need it. Let me open one and let's see. Normally, when you stick this in, you're supposed to hear a click to indicate that it's latch on correctly. There you go. So it did click. So this is the correct one. If you order this unit, you're gonna have to go to Audi and get their factory key to remove the stereo. Some of them might have it and some of them might not. But as you can see, it looks similar to the factory one. So this is the factory one, which I do not like because I don't have Apple CarPlay or whatever. It does have the radio, the CD changer, navigation, but I kind of wanted something more updated. And this looked pretty identical to that, so it still looked factory, and it just plug and play. But you just have to buy the key from Audi and then to remove it. Let me insert all of them and I'll be right back. So to insert the key, the pointed side or the long side is always facing the outer area. So if it's on this side, then it would be facing like this. If it's on this side, then you would turn it and face it like this in there. So when you slide in, you should hear a click. There you go. Real soft. And then here's one up there. So this up top is like this direction, not this direction. Okay? Make sure the smaller end is facing inward. Just a soft. There you go. A click. And there's one in here. You can open this screen to see where it is. I'll just do it for you guys anyway so you can see. This one, you kind of have to turn the car on a little bit. And then you hit this button to open it. Turn off the music. And then that little latch right there. So for this one, it's facing this one, okay? This direction. The small side facing in. Okay, I think that's in there good. Let me close this. Me turn off the car now. So now what you do is you kind of pull out gently each corner to both hands, and then I'll be right back. Actually came out pretty easy. I just did a light pull, and you can see it's coming out pretty easily. Now you just gotta take it out. So here I'm pulling it out, and this is the connection right here. See, you got one up here, a couple down there, or a few, and then that right there. Let me take that out. Okay, guys, so I finally got it out. This piece was the hardest. So there was three. This one on this side, all I did was hit push the underneath to wiggle it out. I'm not sure what that is. And then this one, there was a piece on top. So I just hit that to wiggle it out. And then this big thing, I thought that you have to take from the inside out, but actually from underneath, there's this, you see that? There's that little lever right there from the bottom, and what you do is you push up from it and then release this whole big piece from that right there. See? You just lift up that lever right here from underneath. Let me see if I can get a better view. You see that? You see that little handle right here? So you just lift this up and this whole thing come out. So here's the aftermarket unit. Because this is so clean, it was advertised that it's plug and play. So I'm not too sure if I need all of these wires, but I'm gonna figure it out and then recap with you guys. Okay guys, so I'm just matching male to female. So this one looks like it belongs in here. As you can see, these are for that right there. And then right there is for right there. But in my original one, my original harness, those are over here. So I actually went to the back and moved this to the other side so it can connect. You see that? I took that out from this side and I'm going to move it to this side because from this harness it looks like it's on the opposite side. See? So I finally got it to work. Now it's working. So all I needed to do was to lift this upside down. I had a little issue with getting the power. This wire connected to this, which is, you know, plug and play. This big thing right here, I actually have to move this white piece, turn it around because the connection was on this side and not this side. Originally from the aftermarket unit, it was on this side, so I took this whole strip out and flip it upside down so it can connect on this side. And then there's this little box right here you have to connect. I guess this gives it the power or something. And then you just run that into here. These wires are just my Apple CarPlay and my front view camera and stuff and the antenna. That's all that is. And you just slide that right in right there. That's about it. Let's see if there's volume and stuff on the factory. Definitely hear something. Let's go to music. I don't think there's any music in here at the moment. Let's try radio and see. So there's definitely sound. I think I need to hook up the antenna. Which is this one right here. I guess it's not connected to the factory antenna, so I probably have to put this one in. So give me a second. So I think this piece right here is for the antenna. I'm not sure if the factory one fits or not. I'm going to try to squeeze it in there. If it doesn't, then I'll probably have to install the aftermarket antenna right here, which going right there. So we're gonna see if it works with the original. Okay guys, so I plug in everything and I ran this plug, which is connected to the back of the aftermarket unit, and I just kind of ran it underneath of here. There should be a little entrance. So this is the toggle for the Apple CarPlay, or you can do Android CarPlay. It's just a USB, so you can plug whatever in. But it also have Bluetooth, so you don't really have to do it. And I also have a front camera that's connected to this, so I need to run this around the dash, or just put this up here for now and call it a day temporarily, and maybe in the future I'll run it somewhere behind here. Not sure how to do that yet. Maybe I'll do some research first, but for now I think I'm just gonna stick it here for now. This is a very tight squeeze, so I mean, I think it's going in, but I'm really trying to edge all the edges in real good. So I'll get back to you once I get that done. I finally was able to push this in all the way. It doesn't get inside a gap, but I mean, it's a pretty tight fit. So it's overlapped this piece a little bit on both sides, which is fine. I think it looks pretty good. Look just like the factory. Let's test it out, okay? So here's my other phone. And I love how it says Lamborghini, so it doesn't look like aftermarket. So this the toggle right here. I'm just gonna leave it on the passenger side. My fiance loves to use the phone anyway, so I'm just gonna leave it here. Okay, the radio's on now. Let me connect it to the phone to get the Bluetooth. There we go. See, connected. Look at that. And then you can go to see if it focus. Touch screen. Alright, so I think that's it. So you hit this, you go back to the main menu, and then you right there you can connect to Bluetooth. Let's see if you want to listen to some music real fast. See? Yeah. Excuse the song. I just love the first intro. Yeah. Father God, I just wanna live life. Let me give love pipes. Yeah. Okay guys, so I also wanna show you something cool with this thing. So this does have video tethering. Let me see if I can turn up the flash so you can see. There we go. So right now I'm tethering from my phone onto this head unit. So you can just go directly into here and pick songs and listen to them. Let's see here. See, look at that. Isn't that cool? Instead of using Apple CarPlay, you can just tether onto the unit and then just use this as a tablet. That's pretty awesome. Yeah. So Apple CarPlay, and now you can use it as
I just want to live life. Let me give me loud pipes. Let me give me my all the trial nights. Pull up in the streets. 100,000 on me. Got a nigga that's popping.
Look how quick that is. Just like having a tablet in your car. It's a must for everybody. I think the next thing I'm going to change is this piece. I think some weather, sunlight got into it or something, and it's coming off a little bit. Look at that. You can actually download apps and watch movies and TV shows, anything you want to do. This unit is pretty awesome. Okay, I shouldn't do too much music so they won't block my video. So that's about it. So hopefully you guys like it. And give me a subscribe, thumbs up. Any question, I would be gladly to help you guys install this if you need to. Thanks very much.